The concept of tuning stages wasn't introduced until the 1990s with video games, where stage 1, stage 2, stage 3 were performance packages available to tune your car, and each stage would build upon the previous stage. So stage 2 included stage 1 and a few extra parts. Stage 3 included stages 1 and 2 and a few extra parts, so on and so forth. Since then, these terms of stages have translated into the actual automotive tuner world, but every brand and manufacturer defines their stages differently. Some might call stage 3 a fully built motor, while some might call stage 4 a stock block with a big turbo. The one universally agreed upon definition is that of stage 0. This video is brought to you by me, representing myself on importsauce.com. I've actually gotten back into blogging, and this video was inspired by a recent article that I posted over on Import Sauce. A link to that article will be in the description below. Remember this video where I had my top 10 tips for becoming a DIY mechanic? Well, I wrote that into a blog, and the import staff actually turned that into a podcast. So go check it out. And once you have your tips for becoming a DIY mechanic, then maybe you're ready to tackle a stage 0 tune-up. Stage 0 refers to refreshing a car to better than new operating condition. Generally, this is done in preparation for adding performance parts. Whether you plan on adding a bunch of performance parts and turning up the boost, or you just want to keep a high mileage vehicle on the road going for many years to come, getting the car into tip-top mechanical condition is the first step for a reliable build. Now, stage 0 isn't always about getting the car back to a like-new condition. There's a lot of brand new cars that you can go buy right now, but they wouldn't necessarily be good candidates for performance parts without first addressing some areas of weakness. The costs associated with stage 0 can vary greatly, anywhere from a few $100s to tens of thousands of dollars. It really depends on the make and model of your car, the current mileage, and its maintenance history. The following are my top 10 suggestions for performing a stage 0 tune-up on most gasoline-powered cars. But of course, these are just suggestions, and I highly recommend that you check out the forums and consult with some experts about what they recommend specifically for your car. Number 1, brakes. Check your brake pads and check your rotors. If they're in need of replacement, now's a great time to upgrade. Examine the brake lines, especially on a higher mileage car. And if you see any cracks or signs of leaking fluid, it might be time to replace them. I would suggest eventually upgrading to stainless steel brake lines. These are much more resistant to swelling from heat, and they'll probably last the remaining life of the car. Don't forget to flush your brake system. I suggest doing it every 30,000 miles or even more frequently than that. And I would also suggest going with a more high performance brake fluid, regardless of if you're building a track car or just a reliable daily driver. Going with a high temp brake fluid, while it might cost a little bit more, does provide a bit more peace of mind in the event that your brakes do get extra hot. This is also a great opportunity to upgrade to a big brake kit. You want to make sure your vehicle can stop well before adding more power to make it go faster. Number 2, the transmission. Flush your transmission fluid. If your vehicle has an external transmission fluid cooler, examine that and make sure it's not leaking. If you don't have an external transmission cooler, depending on the build you're going for, you might want to consider one. If you drive a manual transmission car and it has a hydraulic clutch system, make sure you inspect all of those lines and bleed the clutch. And also consider replacing the clutch, the pressure plate, and even the flywheel. Number 3, the cooling system. If coolant flows through it, you should probably inspect it. That includes the water pump, the radiator, any of the coolant hoses, obviously your thermostat and your thermostat housing. Don't forget about your heater core. People often forget about that. Also, if you have a turbo that's water cooled, check the lines running to the turbo. Number 4, the engine lubrication system. Basically, the oil and the lifeblood of the car. Obviously, an oil change should be the first thing you do with a stage 0 tune-up, but you want to inspect the cam seals, the positive crankcase ventilation system, also known as the PCV, a common point for failure on pretty much every car because it can become clogged with time. Don't forget to check any feed lines that run to accessories, including a turbo. And if you have any external oil coolers, definitely examine those. And again, if you're considering upgrading a car or building a track car, you may want an external oil cooler. While you're under a car, also examine the block for any signs of leaks, especially around seals and drain plugs. Number five, the fuel system. That includes your fuel pump and fuel filter. Consider replacing or upgrading the fuel pump if you're going for a performance build. Also, if you have a fuel pressure sensor, those are usually pretty cheap and definitely worth replacing at set mileage intervals because they just become gunked up with time. And also, don't forget about your injectors. You might want to consider cleaning them. You might want to consider upgrading them. Number six, your air sensors and your vacuum lines. This includes your MAF, or your mass airflow sensor, your MAP, which is the manifold absolute pressure sensor. Forced induction cars will usually have a boost pressure sensor. Sometimes this is integrated with the MAP sensor, so just do some research there. Don't forget about after the engine, your oxygen sensors. Most importantly, the upstream O2 sensor, which is a wideband and is going to be responsible for adjusting the air fuel ratio of your car. You wanna make sure that that's in good operating condition. Usually you're gonna get a check engine light once it's gone bad. If you have a high mileage vehicle, you may just wanna consider replacing it anyway because it's probably gotten pretty dirty with time. If you drive a forced induction car, also check out the control valves or solenoids that are responsible for regulating how much boost your engine is actually getting. And of course, inspect all of your vacuum lines, make sure there's no signs of leaks, make sure there's no cracks, and be sure to tighten any hose clamps. Number seven, belts and tensioners. If you have a timing belt or a timing chain, make sure that those have been replaced either at the suggested mileage interval or time interval by your vehicle's manufacturer, and also the tensioners that are associated with those. And also replace any accessory belts, things like your alternator belt, an AC belt, supercharger. Make sure the tensioners and pulleys are in good condition too. Number eight, spark. Replace your spark plugs. If you're going with a performance build and you plan on adding a significant amount more horsepower, you may want to consider a step colder spark plug. So definitely consult with some experts in the forums to see what other people are running with similar setups. Also, this is a great time to upgrade your coil packs or your distributor cap and your coil leads, depending on what kind of car you have. Number nine are your filters. Replace or clean your intake filter. Again, if you're going with a performance build, you may want to consider an upgraded intake filter. Make sure it has a CFM, which is cubic feet per minute. Make sure that it flows sufficiently for the amount of air that your engine is going to need. This is also a great time to clean your throttle body while you have everything apart. And while you're at it, don't forget to replace the cabin pollen filter because, you know, you want fresh air in your car. Number 10, your suspension and your drivetrain. So that includes your shocks, your struts, your springs, your sway bars, end links, tie rods, bushings, CV joints, drive shafts. Make sure everything's in good condition. Consider upgrading it if you need to replace things. And don't forget about your engine mounts. I mean, after stage zero, your engine should be performing pretty well, especially if you plan on adding performance parts. More power means more torque, and more torque is more stress on the engine mounts. So definitely consider replacing those if they're high mileage, or consider upgrading them. And obviously, don't forget about tires, but that's more of general maintenance and not necessarily stage zero. Bonus, I highly suggest installing gauges for anything that your vehicle doesn't have the ability to monitor. Depending on the type of build that you're going for will kind of determine what gauges you should probably purchase and install. But at the very least, if you have a forced induction car, I would definitely suggest at least having a boost gauge to make sure everything's operating smoothly. Of course, no part of stage zero is actually mandatory prior to tuning your car, but making sure that all of the mechanicals of your vehicle are in tip-top operating condition is the first step towards making sure that you have a healthy and reliable vehicle for many years to come.